Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to Okami. It is me, Ralphie993. In the last episode, we found half of the canine warriors Princess Fuse asked us to look for in Kusa Village. And now Issun suggested we go back up and see her. However, we can see that our canine tracker is now flashing again, red this time, and we can see the thought bubbles of another pooch, it looks like. This one not so friendly looking. Hey, Ami! A fleabag's giving you the evil eye. I think it noticed that canine tracker you got there. What's that? My master, Princess Fuse, has summoned me. But first, I wish to try out the skills I've honed on my journey. You hear that, Ami? Princess Fuse forbids me to join in fruitless battles. But I want you to prove your right to bear the canine tracker. Why you? Got a lot of nerve picking a fight with us. Well, bring it on, you fleabag. Right, Furball? Pick a fight? Of course we will. Yep, there's only one right answer. I don't know who this fleabag thinks he is, but he's in for a big surprise. Yeah. These are hard fights against the... I never, ever do well against these guys. Whoop! Their orb will glow like that color. And when it does, they're gonna attack you. So, oh, balls. Oh, shit. Yeah, see, and they do that. Sometimes just one, other times it's a lot more. And all you can do, really, is hit them. And, but granted, they'll become sort of stunned after... Oh, gosh, stop attacking me. Stop it, please. And I'm running low on life. Well, great, we're gonna use the first holy bone I've ever need to use. Because I'm dying. Because... The warriors, there's a reason why the warriors, they're all very, very difficult. And this guy here is kind of like the leader. But if we hit him enough times, he does get stunned. And you can power slash him for damage. And sometimes, after they do the glowy bit there, sometimes they will kind of stop. And if you can hit them long enough, they will get stunned like that, black and white. But that doesn't happen very often for at least... Me, it doesn't. I don't know. Might be better for others. But there we go. That was relatively fast, but apparently you can fight these guys a lot faster than that. Poor time and poor damage. I have no idea how you're supposed to beat these guys sooner. I have no idea. That seems to be the fastest I can do it at all. A worthy opponent, I see. Let us fight where we have more room. You hear that, Ami? Sounds like fun. This time we'll be playing for keeps. Bring it on, fleabag. You're gonna wish you went straight back to Princess Fuse when we're done with you. Hey, wait. If he's been summoned by the princess, then... Maybe this is another one of those Satomi canine warriors. You're just picking up on that now. He's got the sash around his neck with the ball, and you're just guessing now he's a warrior? Jesus. Canine warrior Tay. I'm done toying with you. Now you shall feel the wrath of the Satomi power orb. Whoa, he's a little bit violent. Satomi power orb? Pah! Bring it on, dog breath. We ain't afraid. Oh, Tay! I thought I heard something out here. Oh, he's just a complete puppy when it comes to her. You two aren't fighting, are you? Huh? Fighting? Oh, of course not. Just some friendly wrestling. Look, see? Not a scratch on either of us. Well, granted, Tay looks pretty battled up and beat up. Granted, it wasn't our fault. He was like that before. See the scars on him. Well, at least now we have five of the Satomi power orbs. But you've been naughty doggies! Why did you not come immediately when I summoned you? Hey, princess. What are those Satomi power orbs? Each Satomi canine warrior bears an orb of a different virtue. Satomi power orbs are the Satomi house's greatest treasure. I need the orb's power to break Crimson Palm's barrier. But the canine warriors never listen when I summon them back. And three of them have yet to be accounted for. I fear something may have happened to them. But there is no one I can send out to help them. Hey, what's with that look, lady? Okay, I get the hint. We'll find the rest of them, too. After all, I said we'd get them all back without a scratch. Wonderful! I'll be forever grateful. I know the general location of the remaining three canine warriors. I shall mark them on your map. Oh. Oh, okay, there we go. Some places. You have the canine tracker. They shall return here once you have shown it to them. That is, if they haven't been injured, or even worse. Please hurry. We must get the power orbs and break the barrier. Aw, look at all the puppies. The canine warriors have yet to gather. Tardiness is unacceptable. You hear that, Ami? What a hypocrite. Yeah, tardiness is unacceptable. It took you forever to get here. A worthy opponent, I see. Let us fight again one day. You got it. I'm gonna take you on any time. Right, Furball? Well, we will, actually, later. Yes, we will fight you again. The opponent is covered in evil. We are no match. You got that right, you mutt. That's why you got us to help out. Issun, you got a little bit of a big head there. Oh, what was that? What did you just do to me? Are you a wolf? Where were you born? Yeah, come to think of it. Where were you born, Ami? I have no idea. You bear strange markings. Is that some kind of new style? Huh? Oh, those red marks? I seriously doubt it. Hey, Issun, it is a beautiful new style. You're just jealous. Because I got beautiful divine markings on me. Eh. Anyways, before we head out to go find the remaining of the canine warriors, there's just a few other things I neglected to see on our journey to finding- Ah, I'm stuck. I'm so stuck. Why am I stuck? I'm stuck. I'm unstuck. I'm good now. Just a few other buildings, just what some of the people say. Is it daytime? I can never tell. It will be now, at least. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. But over here, there's a couple of houses. And up here, there's a man. Whoop, with some pigs. We can feed the pigs first. Also, I said once upon a time the pigs will eat anything. No, the pigs only eat the seeds. So there, that clarifies that up. Piggies love. There we go, we can talk to this farmer here. I can't get on with this at all. I'm trying to collect my harvest, you see. But only Mr. Bamboo's baskets can't hold enough of it. Have you been to this house yet, pup? He lives here in the village. I have, actually. Last episode. People come from far and wide to buy his work. He's a real master. But he suddenly stopped making anything. He said he just can't get a hold of any decent bamboo anymore. Come to think of it. Come to think of it what? Don't leave me hanging! Did you come across a slightly ramshackle house at the Taka Pass? The old couple there were the last ones to order bamboo ware. Apparently, they suddenly had a bird cage made for them. They've always hated animals, so I wonder why they want a pet now. Missing Sparrow daughter, a bird cage made. Seemed a little suspicious to me. Let's us go. See what they have to say. Interesting information. So, right now on our plate, we gotta find Satomi canine warriors, the remaining three. We also have to get Sasa Sanctuary open for Mr. Bamboo to get his work done. However, if you recall the map, Sasa Sanctuary is one of these circled places, so maybe we can kill two birds with one stone. Aha, get it? There's a sparrow in. Oh, it was totally unintentional, actually. Go run our way down here. I always feel like the game kind of lags a little bit while running down that part of the mountain, but eh, perhaps not. I don't know. So let's go take a brief look-see, shall we, at the Cutter's place. Maybe we can get some more information about this mysterious bird cage they had made. But here we are. This is not the Mrs. Cutter. Huh? What a tasty looking mutt you are. First that sparrow, and now a dog. This is going to be quite a feast. The dreadful Mr. Cutter. Well then, come on, mutt. It's dinner time. Oh my god, he runs fast. He runs fast. He runs so, so fast. Thankfully, he seems to disappear past this gate. Although it'd be really creepy if he just kept chasing after you, and it would probably terrify me a wee bit. But no worries. None the matter. I don't know if anybody else has also noticed this, but I like it how on their house, they have kind of like those blades up there on the roof. And actually, Mr. Cutter's mustache, those blades just turned upside down. I think Mrs. Cutter also has the blades in her hair, I think, is where she keeps hers. So they kind of incorporate that all together, which is kind of neat. But, well, we can't really do anything with the Cutters right now. We actually have to wait for it to be nighttime. So, in the process, we'll feed those babes there. But remember the fellows at the beginning of Taka Pass? They were all like, oh, my teacup! And oh, I need a pinwheel! Well, we gave the man the teacup already. And now we can give the other fellow the pinwheel he so needed for his wife. So let's do that, just to kill some time. Hello, I brought you a pinwheel. Oh, isn't that one of those famous Kusa pinwheels? My wife asked me to get her one of those. But I've been too scared to go near the place. I don't suppose you'd be able to give me that one, would you? Give him a pinwheel? Sure, we don't really need it. Thanks, Pooch, you saved my life. Now I don't have to worry about getting my wife giving me a wallop. Yay, praise! Sweet deal. So we have 275 praise. How much? Oh, we almost have a full astral pouch. Oh, we just need, like, a few animals to feed, and we could have enough praise to get an astral pouch. Here, we'll do this. We'll dig this guy up, and that gives us a full astral pouch of 200 units of food. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to wait until it's nighttime so that we can then kind of get on with the Cutter's storyline and get into Sasa Sanctuary, find that other canine warrior. So, I'll just wait right here, and I'll see you when it gets dark out. Ooh, spooky. So, it's nighttime now, and we're gonna go back onto the Creepy Cutter property. And remember that hole we blew in the roof, and Issun was like, oh, we should, like, pull somebody into it. Yeah, we're gonna do that now. Let's fall into the hole. Breaking an entry. Again, we do this a lot. But, see our shadow. Mr. Kyler's just there sleeping. She's happy. Why are you happy? Hey, what are you doing back in here again, Mutt? You've got some nerve coming into people's houses like this. You wouldn't even make a decent snack, you scrawny mongrel. My husband got a nice, tasty feast for us to feast on anyways. When it finally stopped tweeting, we can dig in. I can hardly wait. Oh. The moon's very bright again, is tonight, isn't it? Moonlight can be a real nuisance for us, you know. Seems to give us strange powers and make us show our true colors. So it makes it hard to keep up a present pretense of a normal life. And we get so hungry on nights like that, too. She basically told us what to do. We'll just grab her and just drag her into that light. Ark! You saw me! You saw me! Where'd that shadow come from? It ain't human, whatever it is. So you saw me. Now I'm going to kill you. I'm going to eat you all up. Bring it on, you spooks. Come out and fight. No, let's not fight in the house. Don't want to mess that up. Boom. New enemy. I believe these are called Tengus? No, that's not right. I don't know what they're called. We'll look it up after. Anyways, these bird things. Basically, they fly around like dead fish. So, slash off their wings. But then when you attack them like this on the ground, they act like red imps and use their swords to... I see you trying to sense up at me. They use their swords to block and defend. So they're kind of a combination between the two. So they're really easy though, especially with our powered up reflector, and we don't have the floral finisher just yet for them. That's okay. We'll get it soon enough. Really soon, hopefully. I don't know. Maybe 5 episodes. Maybe not even. I don't know. No, 5 episodes. That sounds good. Ta-da! We get the little box. Chirp! Oh, it was so awful being locked away by those monsters. It feels wonderful to be free again. Thanks so much, doggy. Here, let me pet you. Oh, she pets us. Look how cute she is. My name's Chun, precious flower of the Sparrow Inn. Flower of Sasa Sanctuary? Chun. Is this a girl the boss of the Sparrow Inn was looking for? I'd better get home, otherwise Papa will be worried about me. But if I go alone, those monsters might catch me again. Won't you come with me back to Sasa Sanctuary, doggy? Bah, this brat's a handful. Oh well, let's hang with her for a bit. Stupid! Why, you little... Oh, come on, doggy, let's go. Alright, before we fly anywhere, though, let's just briefly take a look at the few enemies we fought this episode. Bestiary, we should have two now. Yes. Here we go. Crow Tengu. Okay, it was Tengu. A creature comprised of the soul of a dead swordsman and a crow. This enemy strikes the skill and artistry of a master samurai. They are often depicted as carrying fans. Cut down throw fans and be even quicker on the draw than them. Swordsmen better than their own make them leave in disgrace. Tales speak of swordsmen cutting the sword defense, which is what we did. Another one here is actually Canine Warrior Tay. Tay stands for brotherhood. Brotherly affection breeds understanding. It allows us to be ourselves and accept our fate. Yes, actually, we'll be getting those for all of the Canine Warriors too. But I'm going to get to a little slow ramble here, slowly walk back with her. She only flies as far as you do. Just to tell you a quick story about how this is all relates to Japanese mythology. So there is a story called the Tonkat Sparrow, and it's about an old man and his wife who live in the forest. And one day the old man, he finds a little sparrow hurt and injured. So he takes the sparrow home with him, nurses it back to health, feeds it, which the wife doesn't like. She's kind of a bitch and doesn't like the sparrow. But one day, both the wife and the husband were out and away, and the wife left out some rice on the counter, and the little sparrow, thinking, oh, this rice is for me, she ate all of the rice. When the wife came home, the wife was not pleased, and she ended up cutting the tongue out of the sparrow. Sparrow didn't die, don't worry, but flew from the house and was terrified of staying there, which is fair enough. Meanwhile, though, when the husband came back, he heard the story and he was rather upset, so he went back out into the woods to look for the little sparrow. And on his way there, he noticed a lot of sparrows, and they led him up into the mountains where the sparrow clan lived in this big inn. So when he got there, they brought him to his little sparrow friend who had flew back to the inn, and they celebrated with festivities and food. It was a grand old time for everybody. Before he left, though, the head of the sparrows decided, here, you may take either this large basket or this small basket as a gift for saving our little sparrow. So he chose the small basket because, hey, it's easier to carry it down this big mountain back home. However, though, when he opened the basket down at home with his wife, there was lots of treasure in it, and the wife was like, oh, well, if there's a bigger basket up higher in the mountains, I'll go up there and get the big basket of treasure. So she goes up there, and the sparrow's like, you don't want the big basket. She's like, no, I want the big basket. Give me the big basket. And so they're like, okay, here, have the big basket. So as she goes down the mountain, she opens up the basket, and inside is not treasure, but a whole bunch of demons, and they frighten her so much that she actually gets scared, falls off the mountain, and dies. There you go. Moral of the story, don't be a terrible person. Don't cut the tongues out of sparrows. But, so, even though the cutters here are both evil people, the old man's also evil, but that's why the Mrs. Cutter has the big basket of demons on her back. Whoop! Sorry. Flipped away. But yeah, that's one of the more interesting stories, I think, that are incorporated into this game. Anyways, let's return Shen, though. Hey, you, Scruffy, what are you doing in Sasa Sanctuary? The whole Sparrow tribe is on high alert at the moment. No one gets through the gates until the boss's daughter is found. Huh? Chun? Hi, I'm back! Chun, are you okay? Boss, she's back! Chun's back! Sorry, Pop! I won't go out on my own again! Sure. Uh-oh. The boss is delighted! Are you sure about that? This white doggy saved me, Pop! You'll give him something to thank him, won't you? Sure. Hiya! Door's open! The boss has accepted you! You're lucky! Okay then, you better come inside. And we have been granted access into Sasa Sanctuary. However, I'm going to call the episode off here, and in the next one, we will go inside Sasa Sanctuary, talk to all the sparrows, get our gift for saving Chun, hopefully find a Satomi canine warrior. Don't forget, that's what we're really after after all. So I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.